Hello and welcome to Plan for the EBV Experts video series. My name is Bernd Gerstenberger. I'm a knowledge domain expert for AutoCAD and escalation lead for AutoCAD Plan for the. Today's topic are the new features of AutoCAD Plan for the 2022. We have several new features to present. Because of that, the new features are presented in three separate videos. This video is the third part of this new feature series for 2022. In this video, I want to present the new isometric dimension setup. The user interface for configuring isometric dimension is strongly improved. I want to present the new feature isometric dimension setup. Of course, since the implementation of the isometric engine, you were able to adopt a lot of things for the isometric output in the project setup. But for a lot of additional tasks, people had to switch to edit the isometric configuration files, like the isoconfig XML file, directly. We know that a lot of people have felt uncomfortable to adopt the isometric drawings directly in these files, especially the isoconfig XML has already out of the box more than 3,000 rows. If you don't understand the structure of this file, you are lost. Now, the good news is that a very important part of the isometric configuration, the configuration of the dimensions, can be done nearly all in the project setup. Only a very small part of the dimension configuration has still to be done in the configuration files directly. Of course, if you want, you can still edit the configuration files directly. Another good thing is that there is no need anymore to look for a good XML editor. The ISO style editor already presented in our Plan3D blog in the pipes formally is integrated to the AutoCAD Plan3D 2022 installation. Let us see how this works. In project setup, two subnodes of isometric drawing settings are completely redesigned. These two subnodes are dimensions and themes. When you look for these subnodes, you might note, if you know the firmware versions, that they are looking completely different. Let us start with the themes section. At the top, there's the normal list of the different ISO styles. Below, you note the three tabs: default piping, override, and branch piping. We will start with the default piping tab. Here, you see a description what exactly is mentioned with a default piping theme and what are branch piping or override themes. But in own words, themes are a part of a configuration which is mainly responsible for the setup of annotations and dimensions. The default piping field will be used by default, like the name is mentioning. But it can be overwritten by an override or branch piping theme if a specific filter condition of a specific subtheme fits. Because these subthemes are smaller, only a part of a default theme will be overwritten. Here in the node themes, you see the general settings of these themes. For example, for the default piping theme, you can change simple scaling, which is by default 20. Or if you want to disable or enable the dimensions or annotations. When we switch to the override tab, you see all the available override themes. Continuation connection piping, existing piping, fitting to fitting, and small bore piping. If you expand the piping details on the right side, you see the filter criteria for the specific theme. when this override theme will be used. For example, for the smallbore piping theme, it can be used for any components which have by default a size of maximum 50 but more than nothing. You can change the maximal size here in the field small bore include size up to. By switching to a different value, the piping details below will be updated immediately. One note about the section enable here. While you weren't able to turn off a bill of material port in the default PAT piping theme, this is possible for the override and branch piping theme. Depending on your needs, you can check or uncheck this option. For the branch piping theme, note that the filter is a bit more complex when these themes will be used. For example, the vent draining theme, which is a sub-theme of a small piping theme, so you have the same settings for the piping details section. But below, you note additional conditions when this sub-theme will be used. It must be start either with nolet, pipe, pipe fixed, or a coupling, and has to end with an end position. It has to contain a valve, but crosses, T's and elbows are not allowed. Also, at the top you see the maximum number of the components, which is by default 6. And the maximum numbers of the pipes, which is by default 1. Note that these settings are disabled and you cannot edit them directly here. This is one of a seldom situation where you have to open the isoconfig XML file directly. But this has been enhanced too. Here at the top of this dialog there's a small button with a name XML. Click that. You might be asked if you want to change your changes. Do that, and then the ISO style editor will be opened. In the ISO style editor, you have two possibilities to view the settings, either in a table structure or in a code structure. You can switch back and forth depending on what you are preferring. It is possible to change things in both views. Both views each have their own strengths. In the code view, the comments are better readable because they are in green on a white background. In the table view, the comments are in dark gray on light gray. But in a table view, it is easy to set the values for the properties, for example, by checking or unchecking a property. Look for the comments what value can be used and what for effects they do have for the specific properties. In a table view, you see a tree view and you can navigate easily through the whole structure. For every node, the properties will be listed. If you see a blue entry, this is a kind of a quick link to a specific sub-node of a current node. For example, when switched to a default theme, you see dimension types. In blue, clicking that moves you directly to a specific sub-node, which might be not the direct sub-node, but a sub-node below. Because these are sections which are configured very often. So let us jump to a specific dimension type. From here we can jump to the anchor points. if anchor points, the anchor points you can set if it is enabled or not, and which filter it has to be used. In the anchor parts you can set, for example, which filter should be used or if the anchor should be enabled or not. From here you can also switch to a filter to see the condition for the specific used filter. In the ISO style editor you might love a search functionality. When I'm searching here with a free text, for example line number scheme, note that the specific part will be shown in bold. Now, you switch through the G-Fur till you see the searched line number scheme. If you are using a more generic keyword for the search, several notes are in bold and you can look for the hits. This was about the integrated ISO style editor. If you have changed something, don't forget to save. Let us go back to the project setup. Now let us take a look for the node dimensions. At the top, you see again the list of the different ISO styles. In the second list, you can see the different themes. In this node, we have four tabs. The first tab setting is for changing general configurations about dimensions. In the section default, you have a live preview for enabled dimension type. This is a way to see in a preview what are the differences of the three dimension types overall, string and locating. For the gasket dimension, you can select a specific dimension configuration from this list, showing each option as an image. At the bottom, you can set the offset and stacking distances of the dimensions. The other three tabs are for the configuration of the three dimension types overall, string and locating. Let us look for a string dimension. At the top right, you see a slider where you can enable or disable this dimension type. On the left side, you see the anchor points, so the components where to set the dimension anchors. You can configure for each anchor point separately if it is enabled or disabled. You are disabling this anchor point by selecting off from the list. But if you want to use this anchor point, you can select how this anchor point should look like. Show the anchor point set to the center of a component or at both ends, etc. Also, you can delete an anchor point in this tab by selecting the corresponding button. I find the new feature that you can add a new anchor point in a project setup especially fun. You can add your own anchor point. Therefore, click the button Add. and new dialog pops up. For example, let us add a valve with the n-type FL and with a specific condition. For example, the size should be 100. Now click button Add Dimension Anchor. Now the new anchor is listed at the bottom of a list. When I select this new anchor, I see the condition for this anchor in the component details. A valve with end type FL and a condition connection size of 100. You can also add an exclusion where no dimension should be created. For example, very often the cap is excluded for dimensioning. So again, we have to click Add, and again a dialog pops up. Let us select cap. Here again, it is possible to specify the end type or an additional condition, but this time cap is enough. All caps should be excluded from dimensioning. Finally, you have to set up a dimension for each type of dimension type and for each theme specific. So, we are at the end of the presentation of this new feature, Isometric Dimension Setup. We hope you enjoy this improvement for an easier way to set up the dimensions for isometric drawings. And this is what I wanted to present in this third part of a new feature 2022 video series today. I hope it was useful for you, and I'm looking forward to your comments for this video. Thank you for your time today. Goodbye.